Valentine's Day Stars. Hey there, stargazers. I'm James Albury, director of the Kika Silva Plot Planetarium in Gainesville, Florida.
And I'm Dean Regas, astronomer for the Cincinnati Observatory. If you want to give your sweetheart something special and out of this world for Valentine's Day, we have a trio of exquisitely beautiful objects in the cosmos, gift wrapped and ready to present.
Let's show you. Okay, we've got our skies set up for Valentine's night, Saturday, February 14th. After sunset facing west, where you'll see an exquisitely beautiful, dazzlingly brilliant object that may look like a star, but a star it is not. It is instead the brightest planet we can see from the Earth. The planet named for, what else? The Roman goddess of love, 8,000-mile-wide Venus.
If you have a telescope, take a look at Venus, and you'll see that Venus is not quite round. Venus is on the other side of the solar system, so it's much smaller now than it will be this summer when it will be much, much closer.
Let's take a look at how Venus will change its appearance over the next few months. Here's our gibbous Venus right now, and let's speed up time and watch as Venus changes its phase and gets much larger as it gets closer to the Earth in its orbit over the next 6 months. Quite a change, huh?
But you can celebrate this Valentine's Day by first showing your loved one the super bright planet of the goddess of love shining down on both of you, which will be prettier than any Valentine's Day card out there.
Then, for a super special cosmic Valentine, look due south between the hours of 8 and 9 p.m., and you'll see a very bright red star shining above the horizon. In fact, it's the brightest red star we can see with the naked eye from planet Earth. And, just coincidentally, it reaches its highest point above the horizon every Valentine's Day between the hours of 8 and 9 p.m.
It marks the shoulder star of the great sky giant Orion the Hunter, and its name is Betelgeuse, which most people pronounce Betelgeuse. And if you've ever wanted to give your loved one a really big Valentine, well, this is about as big as it gets. If we compare Betelgeuse, the Valentine star, with our own star, the Sun, and our own planet, the Earth, you'll understand just how big. Our Earth is 8,000 miles wide, which means it's pretty dinky compared to our Sun, which is 865,000 miles wide. In fact, we could fit over 1 million Earths inside our Sun. Betelgeuse, however, is so huge we could fit over 160 million of our suns inside it. And that's just when Betelgeuse is at its smallest size.
We say smallest size because Betelgeuse changes its size regularly like a gigantic, slowly pulsating heart, one that beats, however, only once every 6 years.
When Betelgeuse is fully contracted and at its smallest size, it is still about 500 times the width of our Sun. But when it expands to the biggest size, it is almost 900 times as wide.
Or, if you care to think of it this way, if we could place Betelgeuse where our Sun is, when Betelgeuse is at its smallest, it would stretch out past the orbits of Mercury, Venus, Earth, and all the way to Mars. But when it's at its largest, it will reach all the way out to Jupiter. Wow.
So, that's Venus in the west after sunset.
The red heart star Betelgeuse in the south.
And if you turn and look east, you'll spot Jupiter the King. It is the biggest and almost the brightest planet we can see from Earth. The planet named for the Roman king of the gods. If you have binoculars or a telescope, just take a look at Jupiter on Valentine's night and look for a close pair of lights above Jupiter. They are two of Jupiter's moons, Io and Europa, and you can watch them separate after an early evening kiss that night.
So, there you have it, a brilliant planet named for the king of the gods right after sunset in the east. In the west, the planet of love, Venus, and due south between 8 and 9 p.m., and at its highest, the biggest cosmic Valentine you'll ever want to give, Betelgeuse, a giant red star slowly beating like a heavenly heart for your sweetheart, courtesy of our local galaxy.
Is this a romantic cosmos or what? Keep looking up.